Good morning. As I've said before, St. Louis County government is committed to serving all of its residents. No one should be left behind. This applies to the response to the COVID-19 pandemic as well. We know that this pandemic has disproportionately affected our African-American residents and those who live in long-term care facilities. But we've also identified another group of residents in our community that are disproportionately affected, and that is our Hispanic or Latinx community. Our Department of Public Health has been working on our data analytics to help us identify and understand those who are affected by COVID-19. We have been converting our paper records into computer records to do this analysis. And what we have learned over the past month is that our Hispanic and Latinx residents are 9 to 15% more likely to be tested positive of COVID-19. That means of all the people that are tested in St. Louis County, 9 to 15% of them are Hispanic. But only 2.8% of our residents in St. Louis County are Hispanic. So our Hispanic residents are 3 to 5 times more likely to test positive for COVID-19. So we're not exactly sure why this is the case. We're working through these analytics and trying to understand. But there may be some reasons. For example, our Hispanic and Latinx residents are more likely to work in a service-related job. They're on the front lines of the COVID-19 pandemic. Some of our residents are more likely to live in homes with their family members or extended families in closer quarters. And this makes it more easy for COVID-19 to move about a family. And we know that transmissions within a household is a likely source of contacting COVID-19 in our community and in the country. We also have concerns that there may be language barriers. So some of our Hispanic residents may not be able to understand the services that are available or have complete access to those services. In light of this data, we are reviewing all of our efforts of outreach in this community with services and information. We're forming plans with leaders of the Hispanic community, and some of them are here with us today. We value their advice and dedication to help keep our residents informed. And I'm announcing today that the County Health Department at both testing locations at the John C. Murphy Center in North County and the South County Center in Sunset Hills will be testing any residents without a photo ID. All we need is some printed material with a mailing address so that we will be able to contact anyone who tests positive and provide them with information and services and help that they need. Our COVID-19 website at stlcorona.com, which you can see behind me, is also available in other languages, including Spanish, through a Google Translate click in the top right-hand corner. On that site, you can make a reservation for a test for COVID-19 at no cost to the patient. We are working on a Spanish language translation of that reservation form as well, and it will be functional soon. As a reminder, anyone in St. Louis County can get a test for COVID-19 at no cost through a reservation at stlcorona.com or by calling 314-615-0574. Finally, I want to make it clear that anyone who tests positive with COVID-19 and is unable to isolate at home can work through their case investigator with the St. Louis County Health Department and may qualify to be isolated in a hotel that St. Louis County has under contract so that you may be away from your family and avoid passing the coronavirus on to a close contact family members. So if you believe that you may qualify, please work through your social worker or contact the St. Louis County Department of Public Health. And now I want to introduce some of our community leaders who have been advising us on our outreach into the Hispanic community and hear from them. Well, first I'd like to recognize Lourdes Bayon. She is co-founder of STL Juntos, and this is a nonprofit organization that provides translation services and other services related to COVID-19 in the Hispanic community in St. Louis County. Sal Valadez serves as a diversity and outreach coordinator for the Midwest region of the Laborers International Union, and he's also a fellow at Washington University School of Medicine. And Diego Abente is a president and CEO of Casa de Salud, which is a nonprofit organization that provides clinical and mental health services to underinsured and uninsured patients in St. Louis County, focusing on the immigrant population and refugees who encounter barriers to access to health care. So, Lourdes, would you like to come forward?
Thank you, Dr. Page. My name is Lourdes Treviño-Bailon. My name is Lourdes Treviño-Bailon. I am the co-founder of SDL Juntos, an organization that has dedicated their efforts and committed to reach the St. Louis region's Spanish-speaking community. Our collaboration with local organizations, agencies, and community leaders has allowed us to bring resources, educational information related to health and emotional well-being, as well as food distribution sites for children. Our goal is to reach and ensure that we, our community is able to get information in Spanish. We are thankful that the county has worked hard to get this data and that we are addressing the health concerns in our communities. Hola, mi nombre es Lourdes Treviño-Bailon. Soy la cofundadora de STL Juntos, una organización que se ha dedicado a traer la información a la comunidad latinoamérica hispana en la área de St. Louis en español. Estamos aquí muy agradecidos que nos han abierto las puertas el Dr. Page y el condado de St. Louis para poder traerles información. Más que nada hemos escuchado todas sus llamadas, sus mensajes que nos han dado y las preocupaciones que tienen. Entonces, ahora que nos han abierto las puertas, estamos aquí para poder traer todas sus preocupaciones al condado. Nos dicen los datos que nos están dando hoy que la comunidad hispana se ha sido un poco afectada, más que la población en general. Queremos que sepan que estamos aquí con ustedes. Necesitamos que sigan las recomendaciones de los salud pública que nos dan. Les pidemos que sean conscientes de lo que está pasando. Como dijo el doctor Sam Page, como latinos somos más probables de agarrar el virus. Podemos más de 2 a 5 veces más que la población en general. Están trabajando para hacer registro por internet, para así podamos todos poder hacernos la prueba. Si van al stlcorona.com, ahí puedes ver la información en español. También puedes registrarte para hacerte una prueba. Quieren que sepan que se han cambiado las cosas. Sabemos que habían tenido problemas porque no podían hacerse la prueba por falta de identificación. Eso ya se ha cambiado. Ya no se le va a pedir identificación, pero lo que sí se la va a pedir va a ser algo para que tenga su dirección de casa. Los problemas que están pasando pueden ser porque las familias hispanas somos más los que vivimos en nuestras casas. Entonces, el condado nos ha brindado el respaldo de poner un local donde si no te puedes aislar de tu familia, puedes llamar y ahí te pueden dar donde te puedes quedar para poder aislarte de la familia mientras que estés enfermo y para que te recuperes. el número de teléfono que puedes llamar para hacer unas para hacer preguntas o si quieres registrarte para hacer reservación para tu prueba es 314-615-0574. ¿Tienen alguien hablando en español? Si no te puedes comunicar, siempre nos puedes llamar. Estamos solamente un mensaje fuera. Nos llamas si te podemos ayudar. También puedes hacer la reservación en stlcorona.com. Muchas gracias. Estamos juntos. Estamos aquí para servirles, para ayudarles. Por favor, sigan la página. Y no dejen de usar sus mascarillas. Mantener la distancia. Si estás enfermo, no salgas. Si necesitas ayuda, pídela. Aquí estamos. Juntos saldremos adelante. Thank you.
Sal, would you like to come up and say a few words?
Sure. Glasses.
Muy buenos días, Dr. Page, por esta reunión muy importante. Hoy está claro, muy claro, que el virus corona está afectando a muchas personas en nuestra comunidad latina, Latinx. El sindicato espera colaborar con el Departamento de Salud Público del Condado de San Luis para comunicar información y recursos esenciales a nuestra comunidad en inglés y en español. También apoyamos los esfuerzos de la red de proveedores de servicios para nuestra comunidad inmigrante en el desarrollo de planes y de servicios para acceso lingüístico. Estos planes son esenciales para mejorar el servicio para la comunidad étnica que no habla inglés en la región de San Luis.
Good morning, everyone, and I'd like to thank Dr. Page, his public health department, and his the diversity departments for today's meeting. And my name is Sal Valadez. I represent the Missouri-Kansas Laborers District Council's Diversity Initiative. We support not just our members, but we also support all workers and their families. And it's very important for us to be part of this, meeting today. It is clear that the coronavirus is affecting many people in our Latino, Latinx community. The laborers are looking forward to continuing our collaboration with the St. Louis County Public Health Department in communicating essential COVID information and resources to our English and Spanish-speaking communities. We also support the Immigrant Service Provider Network, ISPN, Language Access Committee in their ongoing advocacy for the development of language access service plans by both government and non-governmental agencies in our region to better serve the limited and non-English speaking ethnic residents in St. Louis. I thank you very much, Dr. Page, and we look forward to collaborating further with you and our other communities. Thank you.
Diego?
Well, good morning. Again, my name is Diego Bente, and I'm the president and CEO of Casa de Salud. As Dr. Page mentioned, our mission is to facilitate and deliver high-quality mental and clinical health care to our region's under and uninsured. We focus on immigrants and refugees who encounter barriers to accessing these services from other sources. This work has never been as important as it is today, as we come together to respond to this global health pandemic caused by the novel coronavirus. As service providers, it is our duty to uplift and empower all members of our community. CASA is stepping up by providing continuity of care on the clinical and mental health care sides using telehealth. We are also partnering with the Immigrant Service Provider Network, working with local governments to create access to health care in multiple languages and in ways that are culturally sensitive. We also have a very strong partnership with People's Health Center, and through that partnership, we are providing free COVID-19 tests at CASA. We look forward to working with St. Louis County in addressing the long-standing inequities of our region and to making sure that everyone has the information that they need to slow the spread of the virus in all communities. Casa de Salud está a su disposición para proveerle el servicio que ustedes necesiten y les ruego que nos busquen si necesitan esos servicios. Muchas gracias and thank you very much.
Thank you. Well, thank you, Lourdes, Sal, and Diego, in helping us reach so many people in the community and as many as possible to ensure that everyone is getting a better education at the services that are available through St. Louis County Department of Health to our Hispanic residents. As a reminder, I will not be holding a media briefing on Friday, July 3rd. That is a county holiday, and I want to wish everyone happy 4th of July. Enjoy the holiday weekend, and please wear a mask when you're out in public, and I would be glad to answer any questions.